So why don't you use strategic stocks to sort of deal with that so you don't have to have queues?
We had strategic stocks.
Yes, you said you did.
Yes. And in fact, the Mayo refinery closed down for maintenance since January. And you realize that since January, nobody even knew. Not the market was operating.
But is that how long its maintenance takes place?
No, this was a special type of maintenance. We had run into very serious problems with the RFCC.
Which you have resolved?
We have resolved.
But you are saying even throughout that period, there was no. We didn't even realize.
Realize because that time we have stocked.
Because of the liberalization.
Apart from that, we have stocked material. You see, we planned the shutdown procedure.
Yeah.
So if we know we're going to shut down for about, let's say, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, we plan and produce and stock the products that will last for that period of time. And so when we're doing maintenance, we still supply the market, but we take them from our storage depots. Mm.
Is it fair that every time you have something like that, they point fingers at Tema Oil Refinery?
Well, yeah, I'm happy you're asking this. I mean, we take the blows all the time, but that is not fair because currently, you know, Tema Oil Refinery just fits into a market system, which is the oil market system. So it's only part of the system.
Exactly.
And so when there's no product or when something happens, people should blame the entire system.
Yeah.
And not Tor alone.
Yeah.
Because, for example, Tor is not in charge of distribution of the products.
Yeah.
We only produce and supply the market. Yeah. So once a tanker has taken products away from Tor, we have no control.
Educate us about the entire system.
Yeah.
When you say, for example, that rather than just focus on Tor, and I accept that because I was thinking, what other institutions? I mean, the MPA, there's no doubt it has
the
responsibility.
MPA,
who else should we be, you know, thinking about when we are concerned with the shortcomings like that?
Well, okay. You know, NPA is a regulator.
That's right.
So it's kind of the industry coordinator that oversees the whole industry makes sure that crude comes in at the right time and that the products are there and the stocking levels, and they monitor it all the time.
Mm-hmm.
They also set the prices,
review
the prices all the time and make sure that the industry players are playing the game fairly, you know, who owes what to who and all that, and looks at all that. So this is how the system is. But we must understand that a major component of this industry will be the OMCs, the oil marketing companies.
Oil marketing companies.
Because they play a major role in the distribution of the product.
This is the, you know, all the Shell, Mobil, that's what you mean.
That's right.
Yeah.
And so when they lift fuel from us, usually we give them to them on credit, 14-day credit, and they have to sell the products and then pay us back. And they haven't been very, disciplined in that respect.
Mm.
Therefore, we have they owe us a whole lot of money.
You must enforce that. You must collect your money.
We are doing that now. So what we've done is that we've written to all of them, those who have overdue payments with us, we have cut them off. And so the time that we had the shortage on the market, some of them were not actually shortage. Some of the filling stations really were people we had cut off.
Yes.
So whether there was fuel in the system or not, they were not going to have fuel.
But when you cut them off, we will suffer.
Well, only temporarily, because, you know, businessmen will not sit idle and have their businesses collapse.
Mm.
So they.
So why should you?
Yeah.
Why should Todd
sit
down?
So what we like to say here is that the public should understand this. And when there's that shortage due to the misbehavior of the oil marketing companies, and we announce that we have cut them off, they should understand that it is business practice. We didn't anticipate that even cutting them off will cause problems on the market, because as I'm saying, deregulation is designed to work that way. When there's a shortage in one area, the other, the market players come in to fill the gap. That is how the market.
But deregulation is not working. Is it working?
I think so.
You think so?
Let's put it this way. It would have been worse if we didn't have deregulation.
You think so?
Yes. Because if we didn't have deregulation, then the government will be saddled with finding money to import the crude, and the toll will be a burden to supply the crude because there's no other player in the system. Deregulation was meant to free government
yes.
of having to commit huge amounts of foreign exchange in importing crude oil.
Mm.
This role is now being played by the private sector, yeah. and so government has been relieved of that obligation,
yes.
and it is good. It is good to have competition.
But you say that, but you sit at the top of a monopoly.
No, it's
you
not.
Is it not a monopoly, the Tema oil refinery?
No, it's not a monopoly.
No?
Maybe, you see, it's not a monopoly because products, what we do, we produce the products. Petrol, diesel, kerosene, that kind of thing.
Mm.
And yet the system, because of deregulation, allows the private sector to also bring these products in. So it's not a monopoly. Maybe you're saying a monopoly because Tema Oil Refinery is the only refinery.
Precisely.
But you don't look at it by what it does. You look at it by what product it puts out and whether the products are coming only from Tor. If Tor controls all the products that are on the market, then it's a monopoly.
Mm.
But this is not the situation.
So a couple more refineries, would you advise that other refineries to compete with the Tema Oil Refinery?
Well, you know, I'm looking at the health of the whole economy. And I think it's a good thing to have more refineries. What it does is that it just puts a pressure on me to ensure that the government-owned refinery sits up, becomes more efficient, and compete fairly and squarely with those that are coming in.
So there are refineries coming in?
There are. And the good thing is that it's government policy to become a net exporter of energy, including petroleum products, including electricity and all other energy forms. Therefore, we cannot depend on only Tor. Mm. Otherwise, Tor, it will be myopic. No, we're looking at only a small market.
Let's talk about the almighty debt.
Yeah.
You know, Dr. Ampofo, Tor has a big debt.
Mm.
It has been there for many years.
Mm.
You have come to head the institution and it's there.
Mm.
What will you do about it?
I'm glad that you've defined the environment in which I have been placed.
Mm.
But I think the appointing authority knows the caliber of people that it has and chose me to be at all.
Mm.
Yes, the challenges are huge, but I'm not intimidated by them because I feel where you have determination and you have the support of the appointing authority, the ministers, and all those that make the industry work, the NPA, and God on your side, surely you turn things around.